Hello, folks, and welcome back to Tyranny. As always, of course, I am Falcon, your host. Folks, please like the video. It helps it to be more popular. Subscribe to my channel because it helps you find my content if you enjoy it more and helps me a great deal. And please check out my Patreon. Link is in the available in the top right corner of the video, down in the description of this and every video, and also at the end of the video. The Patreon is very important because going forward, I intend to try to create content with my community and with my viewers who subscribe in the Patreon in ways that I think are unique and I haven't seen anybody do, so please do check that out. Okay, so we're picking up in the new area, the area that we were tasked to go to, Effigy, which is very near the Burning Library, which is ultimately our objective for coming up here. Having said that, I spent quite a bit of time in the spires, wandering around, doing a few things. Nothing hugely important spire-wise, as far as like the actual interactions with the spire itself. But I did talk to all of my companions quite a bit. I actually spent a good deal of time, particularly talking to Ebb, Kills and Shadow, and Siren. Well, not so much Siren, because I'd already mostly talked to her. But Ebb and Kills and Shadow. As you can see, I actually have unlocked Kills and Shadow's loyalty thing, and did a little bit with Ebb, but I already had hers, so it wasn't a whole lot to do with her. But I did gain a good deal more background, story, and information and stuff. I apologize that I didn't show any of that in the video. However, the amount of time it takes to go through the conversations and stuff, and the amount of dialogue trees and things, options that there are great. In a lore-building, story-building, and character-building way. But they don't probably make for very interesting video, because it would have been me just sitting there reading the thing for literally like an hour. Like, I literally sat there for almost an hour between the two of them, talking to them, and learning some stuff. And I also talked to Lantry a little bit more, and we'll get to that in 1 second. I learned more about Kills and Shadows' tribe, where she came from. Apparently she's the last of the tribe. The Shadow Hunters were all dead, which of course it says right there, but she gave a little bit more information about that. Gave some information about their magic that the tribe does, although I wasn't able to access some of that, because apparently you need, like, really high loyalty to gain some of those answers from her. Similarly, I talked to Ebb, learned a little bit more about the Tide Caller, the School of Tides, and the their Archon, and some of the things that they came from, as well as some more background information on the Tears in general that she was able to provide as well. It was some interesting stuff, and if you do play the game, I highly recommend talking to her, because it really provides quite a bit of background information into the world that's in general, not just her, or even the School of Tides. And then finally, I did do some more talking to Lantry. Managed to gain his fear up a little bit more. Might have got his loyalty up slightly as well. But most of the options that I did take, I was trying to get his fear up so I could get the his fear ability. But the most important thing is, I discovered where you can learn the freaking stupid healing spell, which I have been looking for the whole goddamn game, and only just now realized that he teaches it to you. He is where you get it from. It might also be possible to find it somewhere else, but he is the easiest way, the clearest way, and the most guaranteed way to get it. It is apparently possible, reading on the internet, which is actually how I discovered that he was the one who teaches it to you, it is apparently possible to have this bug, and he won't give it to you. At least it was. Admittedly, those posts were back when the more closer to when the game came out, so whether that is still a problem or not, it's probably unlikely, but so, his Restoring Touch, which is the healing spell he's had the whole game, is now vastly improved. It was basically the really, like, super basic thing. Yeah, this is what he had. Like, it was super basic. But now, of course, the one that he's using is maxed out with everything that I can have on it. And it's pretty badass. It does 40% health instead of 26, or Well, for him, it was doing like 30, and now it does 46 because of his skill level. But hugely improved. It's a little bit shorter cooldown on it, so we can use it more often, and has better range, which is really important because had to get really close to use it before. He also now has... I replaced his really crappy buff spell that, frankly, I never use and was pretty fucking useless. With another healing spell, which is a more ranged ability. It also has a little bit of an AoE effect. Which is cool. Can't max that out entirely because this was a pretty expensive spell in comparison. But still has it maxed out to a degree. And then I also gave Barrick a version of the good healing spell without some of the bells and whistles that the one the Barrick Lantry has. But still does substantial healing, so it is still very, very good. Make no mistake about that. Now there is a vital body one, which is a regenerative, like heal over time thing that you can cast on somebody. And seems reasonably okay. And then there's this one, which I actually like even more than the regen one, which is the healing aura, which you cast it on somebody, and everybody around them in a certain radius will be healed for basically the same amount of health that this one heals them for, which is the primary reason why I think it's this one is better, although it does have a longer cooldown and a significantly higher lore required. I was going to take this instead of like this one, but to really max the spell out in ways that I would want it to be maxed out anyway, primarily the radius and the increase that it gives, although the duration would be nice too. You would need 200 lore to maxed out the most important ways. And that's not even to count if you want to throw in, you know, some of the other effects, but 200 lore, though, that's a lot. Way the hell more than I have available right now, so a little difficult for me to actually be able to pull that one off. Definitely a bit on the difficult side. But we do now have a people who can actually cast, you know, we can make the healing spell now, so it's actually possible for me to kick Lantry out of the party if I am so inclined, which I couldn't do before, and was actually the main reason why I wanted to get the spell. Because it gives us more options now, and I could actually go and get... and might go and get... either Ebb or Siren. Probably Ebb? Although, I do like Siren too. Like, I wouldn't mind having either of them, really. Siren, we can maybe get her loyalty and fear up some enough that maybe she, you know, we could actually unlock one or two of her abilities. Because right now we can't. But, eh. Kills in Shadow is also pretty cool. She has no ability to... She could be a replacement for Barrick. She doesn't have the tanky, like, armor that Barrick has. So she doesn't have the defense, but she has, like, a ridiculous amount of health. Like, she is a straight health tank. She can just soak damage. And she also does a lot of damage because she can use a dual-wielded weapon in one hand. She can use a two-handed weapon, rather, in one hand. She can't use two of them. She can only use one weapon. But still, she can do a lot of damage. I did upgrade the Dauntless to the maximum level, Masterwork. So it's as good as it can get right at this point. I also upgraded the Gravebow, the two artifact weapons that we have available to us right now, are both maxed out. And I upgraded the armor for Barrick and just kind of the armor in general for some other people as well while I was there. We're doing pretty good. I might go at some point after this episode, I may transfer over, or once we finish with this area, I may transfer Lantry, kick him out and get somebody else. Just because I like his character, but I like It's a pretty good bow if, you know, we didn't have the grave bow, which is better just because it's a... Better just because it is a artifact. See, it actually does more damage, but does lose the, you know, the fact that it's an artifact and some of the other effects. So, ultimately, probably not worth the time. Although, actually, it's probably a good replacement for this bow, now that I think about it. Because... Oh, but you lose the armor penetration, though. And the range, actually. The DPS is really not that much worse. No, actually, because of the armor penetration, I don't think it's as good as I might have thought it was. I might actually even just sell it. I don't know. It is a named weapon, so maybe I'll keep it. I have tried to keep most of the named weapons up to this point. So, I don't know. I don't know how much I really care, but... We do need to get going, though, because we have wasted a substantial amount of time talking. Well, there's nothing wrong with that. I don't really want to waste the entire episode just sitting here blabbing for no good reason. Oh. What's going on here? Why are there beast men here? Or beast women, perhaps, as the case may be. Well met, Fatebinder. What's going on here? We captured his favorite soldiers skulking around the area. Renata is deciding what to do with them. Sages must die for Graven Ash. Can I talk to the prisoner? Absolutely not. Renata said no one was allowed to see him if she was not accompanying them. Okay. Well, I will come back then. I will come back then. I guess that's Merrick. Oh. Merrick. Oh, that's the guy that we were tasked to come find. Ah, right. I don't really want to kill the sages. I'm going to try to avoid that if we can help it. Because I don't feel like the sages are really bad people. In fact, I think they're actually good people. Reasonably, at least. Although, you know what? We are going into an area that's all about the sages, so I should probably keep Lantry around, at least until we finish this vicinity. Then I might swap him out for Ebb. Or somebody else. But I don't really want to, get rid of him while we're going into the sage area. So you notice a young woman standing apart from the rest of the sages. She fidgets and twitches, hopping back and forth from foot to foot, murmuring to herself. Even though she seems energetic, her eyes are tired and rheumy, with dark circles underneath them. She leans against the wall, bouncing up and down the balls of her feet. Looking up, mid-twitch, she catches your eye and calls out to you. So you are a sage's guild, okay. You there! Yes, you! Can you help me out? I have so much that needs to... Oh, wait, I thought you were someone else, and this is incredibly embarrassing, so never mind, because you're not who I thought you were. And so you can't help me, and it would be a waste of my time to ask you everything, only to find out you can't help me, because I know you can't, because... yeah. Oh, my. Trying to read it like it's written is really difficult. Because I know you can't help me, because you're not the person I was looking for, so thanks for listening, but I need to keep doing my research now, so I'll go over there. She bounces and twitches a few feet away, leans against the wall again, muttering to herself. Okay. You have way the hell too much energy. Oh, hello. Oh, wait. It's you again. For a second, I thought you were someone else again. That would have been funny if I'd asked you. You crazy. Like, really crazy. Renata. As you approach, you see a stern-faced woman having a heated discussion with a frightened young man. She holds a piece of paper in her hand and punctuates every few words with a pointed tap on the sheet. The young man turns bright red and takes two shuffling steps backward, his eyes casting about for help from the group, but no one gathered will meet his gaze. Finally, the woman throws the paper at him and says dismissively, "We're done here." Okay, dude just ran the fuck off. The young man makes a couple of frantic grabs at the paper before finally securing it, then turns and runs away, tripping as he goes. The woman squeezes her eyes closed, sighs, and puts the palm of her hand against her forehead, working around in small circles. She takes another deep breath and then turns to face you. She gives you a half bow, her face stoic and her voice flat. Fatebinder. The last thing I expected here was a representative of the disfavored. My name is Renata. We are not properly prepared to receive you, as we have recently taken a prisoner, and he has proven to be quite the handful. She puts a hand to her head again, as if to emphasize her consternation. And I have the feeling you're probably here to speak of just such matters. She looks at where the young sage disappeared behind a building. We are... She pauses and looks up thoughtfully. How do I say this diplomatically? We're rather short-staffed at the moment, and certain aspects of my day-to-day are more difficult than I would hope. She glances at you, a look of distaste clouding her face. Because we didn't have quite enough time to evacuate before our home was destroyed, which of course was our conquest decision, we lost many good men. She smiles stiffly, but that's all in the past, isn't it? Gained major wrath, really. Wow. So we gained major favor with them before, and now we just gained a lot of wrath too. So we're gonna get their ability. We're gonna get their abilities without even having to do anything. But it's the behalf of the sages. I've come in search of someone named Merrick. I've learned that he may be here. She smiles and points toward south towards the house of the sage and beast man standing in front of it. He's here, all right. He's our captive, and he isn't going anywhere. I'd like to talk to him. Folds her arms and looks at you incredulously. Well, considering he was probably sent to finish the job the edict started, which would mean you're probably here to check up on him, why would I ever let you do that? I just want to see him briefly. You might be more inclined to talk to me. Absolutely not. Less than I need is for you to colluding against me. Now I'm incredibly busy and have work to do, so leave me be. We're not criminals, Sage. Whatever else you might think, we are the ones in the right here, and you are simply an obstruction to move aside. By force, if need be. She scrutinizes Barrack with a mixed expression. Easy for you to say when you stand as tall as the library stacks. Come down to my level if you want to pick a fight, you great iron spire. Ash has commanded me to speak with Merrick. You are standing in the way of Kairos' forces. And I have a scattered group to collect and lead. Everyone has hardships, and I really don't care to hear about yours. Kairos has done enough damage. I will not allow it to continue while I'm here. You can bluster all you want. You will not be speaking to the prisoner. I won't ask again, Renato. Let me talk to Merrick or pay the price. Her eyes narrow. Appears you wish this to end in blood. So be it. You'll find the sages aren't so easily silenced. Guards! We're under attack! Oh, you really, really shouldn't have done that. I was trying to be reasonable. I was trying to be friendly. I was trying to not slaughter you all. That's no longer the case. Since you have elected the path of pain. Alright, well, blow that guy up. Alright, so that will... The taunt... Oh my, what the hell did you just do? No, but seriously, what the hell did you just do? Hunter's Cry. Oh, the Beast Woman did it. Interesting. Maybe you should stop doing whatever the hell stupid shit you're doing and... Stop, you dumb fucker! Shit, we're getting our ass kicked because you're freaking retarded. The only plus side is the fact that we no longer have the penalty. We no longer have to, The only plus side is we simply no longer have to suffer the penalty of not having, multiple healing spells and stuff, because that's just not a thing anymore. Wow, this fear effect has really fucked me. How long does this thing last? Okay, it's almost over. Wow, that fear effect really fucked me. Like, we are dying here because of that effect. Like, that thing has really screwed me. Like, really bad. Like, really bad. I guess cast it that direction because ultimately it does more damage that way. Although I would rather have done it a different way, but... Nevertheless, I'll take it, I suppose. All right, really need to deal with these guys, so we need to blow these guys up, like, as quick as possible here. And probably need to do the healing ability, which is I would rather not. The fortunate part is this will heal everybody in the group, so... She should probably cast it on him, because he needs the healing more than the rest of you do, but... Did you even cast your spell? I didn't see it go off. Not that that means anything, mind you, because I wasn't really paying attention, but... Bullshit that you just got wounded. Like, the wound system is mildly ridiculous. It really is. Because... just because of the way it works. Bicycle Storm, unfortunately, is really just going to have to be used on these two, because we don't really have the opportunity to use it against anyone else. Then you can Ball Lightning down here. Unfortunately, you really can't hit the people I want you to hit with it. Now you can, though. So I'm down with that. So go ahead and do that. Ooh, dude, just got blown the fuck up. Wow. Alright. That worked. Yeah, guy just got really blown the hell up. Dude just, like, detonated. It's pretty funny, actually, but... Pretty funny, actually, but I will take it. Well, that did some damage. That combo of spells there just really blew those guys up pretty effectively. Definitely did some work. You need to go heal her, though. What are you doing, dumbass? Oh my fucking god. Seriously, asshole. Seriously. You are taking a shit ton of wounds. This is not good. What are you doing, dumbass? What? Like, seriously, what the shit are you doing? Oh, you got frightened again. Fuck off with that bullshit. God damn it. Do you mind? I don't know why you're focusing on her in the first place. Because you're not fucking supposed to be. Are you afraid of death? Did you stop knocking me down, you dick? Blowing the fuck up. You just got blown the fuck up. Yeah, I've had quite enough of you. Quite enough of all of you. Quite enough of all of you. Yeah, blow this person to bits, please. Right. It is quite time to blow this person up. There. God, that was annoying. Cowl of Disbelief. Okay. It's a cloth armor, which is generally pretty bad. The only thing that's kind of good about it is that magic defense buff that it has. But frankly, I don't think that that's worth the decrease in everything else that we would suffer from it. In comparison to what we're using otherwise. So, how many wounds did you end up taking? I don't actually remember how we check that. Whatever. What do you want? I've already faced enough torments at the hands of these scholars. The bound prisoner squints up at you and licks his dry lips. You're Tunan's Fatebinder, aren't you? I'd recognize you anywhere. You're the one responsible for muzzling those troublesome sages. Consider it a stroke of genius. Not only did you keep the sages under control, you hampered the censor's efforts to explore the library. They can't talk to the sages, they're not going to get a lot of help out of them. I'm afraid you have to be at a disadvantage right now. I'm at your mercy. Oh, I could kill him, wow. It must be Merrick. Ash has tasked me with destroying the library, so I need your help to get past the course. Merrick looks dismayed. So Craven Ash sent someone to finish what I couldn't do. I know I failed my mission, but I didn't know I was going to be given a chance to redeem myself. So be it. No point in mourning that what I cannot change. As for your problem, I wish I could help you, Fatebinder, but at present, I can't even help myself. What happened to you? My scouts and I were infiltrating the burning library, one of my best. Jelena must have been working with the Scarlet Corps. She disappeared shortly after we were hunted down. She used her oath-bound connection against us. That's how the Corps was able to pin down our location. Damn clever. Don't know how many of us were taken, but those sages caught me while I was resting. I suppose I should feel grateful. Now I just await my execution. Unless you're willing to help me. Set me free and we can talk more. That'd be a real favor, and if you were worried about the muscle around the camp, the rest of my scouts are nearby. They can help us fight off the sage scum. Yeah, they're already dead. You're free. America's been joined by members of his unit, too weary-looking and oath-bound with large patches of ash and blood blanketing their armor. They nod to the commander as they approach, a curiously nonchalant reaction to his rescue. Merrick appears to regain some strength at the sight of his man. He beckons vigorously as you approach, a determined expression visible on his face. Oh, thank you for your help, Fatebinder. I'll forever be in debt to you for helping me to avoid the shame of a dishonorable death on top of my other failure. I am afraid I must ask more of you, even after you've already done more for me than I can repay. First, you'll help me. I need to get to the library. I'll tell you everything I know. I only ask you to do something for me once you make it to the library. Graven Ash tasked me and my group with destroying it. Unfortunately, we were discovered and routed, but I know how to get you in there safely. Here, let me mark on your map how to bypass all the chorus patrols to get to the library. Once there, you need only deal with the sensor to get inside. But be aware, Fatebinder, one of my soldiers mentioned a large, magical barricade deep inside the library. The sensor has regained searching the entire building for parts of some kind of passcode to get beyond it. If you're going to accomplish your goal, you'll need to find the passcode before they do. I wish I had more information for you, but I hope that will help you. He salutes you. Now I would make my request of you. What is it? Some of my oathbound scouts are still missing. Two are in the burning library. The third, Jelena, is in the Scarlet Chorus camp. I want to see her properly punished for her betrayal, as much as I want to see the others saved. What about this betrayal? She used her oathbound connection against us. That's how they were able to pin our down a location. We already basically told us that. Because you helped me, I'll tell you, but normally this knowledge is not shared outside the disfavored. If you are truly an oathbound, you must complete a ritual that connects you to each one of your brothers. Their feelings become yours, their pains are your pains, and their troubles are yours as well. Jelena used that connection to betray us. She must be made to pay for that act. What do you want me to do? I ask you to find my missing men and return them to me. Jelena must be made to pay for her crimes, and I will not have another of my men lost to her weak will. I'll find your men and return them to you. Thank you, Fatebinder. I'm in your debt. I will not hide the fact that without your help, I would have failed in my mission. Your name will be praised as long as I can draw a breath. I'll await your return here.
On it.
Oh, good? Question mark? So we have found a new thing, which is this. Don't really care that much about that. We did just unlock the one ability with the sages. Ooh, it's plus 6 lore. That's nice. I will take it. We're almost there on their favor ability. And we are actually not too far away from getting the upgraded Wrath ability too. But we do have the passive abilities here for both, which is nice. I will happily take that. So, okay, so we have to go enter the ruins. Alright. Did I miss something over here?
Sorry, I can't.
There used to be something to loot that I somehow missed. So it appears, anyway. Oh yeah, what the hell is this? How did I not see it before? Oh well, whatever. Alright, so carrying on. We can go to the Burning Library now. I could go back, but having a sage with us is probably helpful, so while I wouldn't mind having Ebb with me, I think I want to keep... Although, we could get rid of Verse. We are kind of fighting the Scarlet Chorus, but not directly so much. So... Now, for now. Yeah, for now, I think I will stick with the people we have. All right. Hold on. Okay. So this is the library itself. We might get to do... We won't be able to go inside of it. We just don't have the kind of time that we would need. Oh. Hello, Scarlet Chorus people. I don't think I want to deal with you just yet. Let's explore the outskirts here a little bit before
Sorry,
we do anything with that.
The
corpses of sages are skewed on these spikes. Skin has been blackened by the heat of the magma, belching from nearby fissures. Yeah, so this is the, we actually have an opportunity to end yet another, edict if we, can complete this. We have to do... What does the edict exactly say? It is... Something for as long as forbidden knowledge lies within the heart of the Vellum Citadel. So we need to get to that forbidden knowledge and either A, take it for ourselves, and just take it out of the place, which probably would do the job. Enemies. Don't know that I want to fight enemy people just yet. We are not going to manage to complete this area, this episode, obviously. We don't have that kind of time. We don't have even close to that kind of time, in fact.
Let's be off.
Will do.
Don't recognize your authority here, Fatebinder. Doesn't do much for me. I mean, if you're not going to just immediately attack me, I'm going to ignore you for a moment while I look around. Which does not mean I'm not going to fight you, it just means I'm going to... not immediately fight you.
Sorry, I can't. On the lookout.
Say, you should be able to stealth and maybe detect something, although
Sorry,
it doesn't look
I
like
can't.
There's anything to detect. Which is unfortunate. Shelf is well separated from the surrounding area and looks quite perilous to scale. Strange rocky protrusions can be seen along the top, like likely magical in nature. What the fuck are those? Also, that looks like a passageway. Interesting. Alright, so who the hell are you? Twisted Man leans over two forms on the ground, one a robed figure covered in bruises, the other a soldier, horribly burned, lying motionless to the side. Man grunts at you with obvious displeasure. If it isn't the betrayer herself, he spits. If you want anything here, you need to meet the censor. She's to the east, by the ruins' entrance. You should go now. Very well. If you come to torture me too... I mean, apparently I could probably kick your guys' ass, but unless we have a really good reason to, I'm not gonna bother. So let's take a little bit of a gander at what's up here. Soldier walking past catches a glimpse of you and immediately points her spear towards you. The censor will be very interested in your presence, Fatebinder. She's near the entrance of the library. Go. Now. Well, considering that's where I was already headed, maybe you can shut your face. I'll pick up potions. Junk. Boltok. Okay. I don't know who the fuck you are. I have a feeling you are probably merchants and people that we could talk to if we had decided to side with them, but since we didn't, these are just people that we would have to kill, I'm assuming. Anyway. I mean, maybe there's something else that we could do here, but I think to have any real interaction with these people, we would have had to side with the Scarlet Chorus. Oh, there's Jelena. Why the hell are you tied up? Doesn't entirely make sense. Isn't clear how one might remove it. His favorite soldier sags heavily against her rope, emaciated and weak. Her clothes reveal her to be one of the Oathbound. Fatebinder, you're no enemy of the disfavored. My life is worthless. Perhaps you can help my brethren. Please. Merrick wants you dead. Merrick is right to want me dead. I tried to help my unit, but I betrayed them in the process. When this is all over, I'll submit to whatever judgment I'm owed. I wouldn't expect you to preside over my sentencing. That you're talking to me now is more than I deserve. How can I help? To my knowledge, two members of my unit are still alive and pinned down in the burning library. I'm in no shape to go after them myself. If you managed it, I'm sure that Merrick would appreciate knowing that his troops weren't completely devastated. All I can say is that you'll find them in the library. I can't pinpoint where they are. Well, you know both of them are injured. Tread lightly, Fatebinder. I fear that place is far from stable. What happened to you? I came here with a unit of Oathbound scouts and our leader, Merrick. We were trying to locate the Silent Archive. We saw that the place was overrun with Scarlet Chorus. We resolved to destroy the Archive so that its contents didn't fall into the wrong hands. I crept along the surface while the others descended into the depths. As the hours dragged on, I got clumsy. Someone caught wind of me, and a man they call Murmur has been my tormentor ever since. She grimaces in introspection. He was keen enough to know the Oathbound can feel each other's presence. It makes us powerful on the battlefield, but it's a crippling disadvantage if anyone gets captured. Any disadvantage is crippling. Those fools insist on learning everything the hard way. It devastates me to admit that I eventually broke. Whatever else they are or claim to be, the Chorus are persuasive. I fed them as many lies as I did facts, betting the Chorus would busy themselves with the search and give the Oathbound time to escape. I heard around camp that Merrick made it out, but I don't know about the others. I could release you. It's better than I deserve, but so be it. I was content to die by the censor's hand. I betrayed my unit and cost them their lives, after all. But as you've seen fit to release me, I'll find some discreet cover and lay low until you've retrieved my brethren. Good luck. I mean... Eh? Oh, she's willing to meet judgment from Merrick personally. Okay. I don't know that I necessarily want to talk to the censor person. I can't. Although I don't think we're going to have an actual option at the end of the day, but... So I guess we'll finish this part, and then that will probably have to be the end of the episode. We'll continue on at that point with whatever we have to do. Alright, so what do you want? Stay your weapons! This is Tunan's Fate Binder. Sensor makes a swift motion to her soldiers, then pauses to look you up and down. And what a complicated pleasure it is to find you in my camp. This is supposed to be a girl, but I can't really do girl voices very well, so... Now what would Ash's plaything want with my library? He seemed particularly happy that he decided to throw your lot in with the disfavored instead of the Scarlet Chorus. It wasn't enough to betray Nerat and side with the rule-bound control freak. Are you here to try and take this away, too? The only reason I've instructed my soldiers to show restraint is because of the sensitive operation ongoing in the ruins, one that I don't intend to disturb. The players in that little game have enough to keep themselves occupied. That said, I wouldn't hesitate to kill you if it proved necessary, so why don't you tell me what you're doing here and we'll see how this goes. I'm just passing through. Gain some favor with Blood and Mark. I kind of like that one. Let's go with the athletics version. A blood chanter glances nervously around at his comrades, wiping his sweat-filled brow. He backs away slowly before breaking in to run, careful not to alert his allies. Undude just backed the fuck out. He's like, I'm out of here. Well, nothing to do with that. We intimidate the shit out of him. Well, you'll create the aggressor, aren't you? That might intimidate one of these weak-kneed shits, but I've been in the game far too long to be impressed. I'll give you another option. Lay down your arms and surrender. She rolls her eyes, unperturbed by your aggression. I don't have time for this. Nonsense. What a place. There's a time and place for bloodlust, and sadly, I've got an operation to oversee. We're under attack! Kill the Fate Binder! Throw yourselves at her if you must! You have made a horrible mistake, friend. Just want to make that very clear. You have made a horrible mistake. And I will happily, happily teach you that mistake.
Trouble.
I will be more than happy to teach you that mistake. No, don't be casting ball lightning. That's not the spell that you should be doing anything with. What the hell are you casting, anyway? What are you casting? Why are you trying to cast a special ability? Do that. You're retarded. I don't know what the hell you're doing, but stop it. No, stop with the trying to cast spells, you dumb crap.
Do it for the north.
On it.
Stop with the trying to cast spells. You're casting the wrong spells on the wrong people. First and foremost. Oh, why are you trying to attack me? Yeah, get the hell out of here. Leave Landry alone, dude. You didn't do nothing to deserve your bullshit. You did nothing to deserve your bullshit, so stop that crap. You need to finish what you're doing. Oh good, you got lit on fire. Great. Just what I wanted to see. I mean, that kind of hits all of them. Not very effectively, but I mean, it kind of does the thing that I would want it to do there, so... I mean, I guess that's a good thing. I suppose. More or less. Who has that one spell ability, anyway? Or the one item ability, rather. You do, there it is. I don't use this very often, so I'm going to use it now. Because we rarely get an opportunity to actually use it, because I just don't. I never remember to use it, really. Okay, you can actually do it yourself now, since you do have that spell. Which is cool. Because we didn't used to be able to do that. So it's nice that we have that ability now. It is nice to have that ability now. I was going to say, please blow up this person.
Will do.
For me. Because I don't like their face. And I would prefer that they exploded. Alright, do that because it'll pass through and hit everybody. Your icicle storm. Oh, it can hit them all, both of them. Okay. Cool. So let's say I probably can't hit both of them, but it actually did. It actually did. And I guess you can blow this person up because screw him. And what else do you have? Just icicle storm yourself. Okay. Well, come over here and use that, I suppose. And that's... you're dead. We blew everybody up. Alright, I guess we can go kill that other group real quick. Maybe. I'm actually a little reluctant to even bother with them, to be perfectly honest with you, but... is this armor an upgrade for anyone? Probably not. Although it might be an upgrade for some of the people who aren't presently in the party. In fact, it probably is. So I will definitely take those. They're just not gonna do much for me right now.
I got it.
Oh, hi. How are you doing? Tell you how you're about to be doing. Badly.
I will break you.
Very badly. Oh, you just detonated. Well, congratulations. Oh, did that hurt me? What the hell happened there? What was that? Shattering the bonds did a shit ton of damage to the people that were engaged with them. I don't know what that ability was, but it hurt, whatever it was. Hi. You were totally not paying attention. What are you doing, Verse? Why are you apparently an idiot? I mean, you did. So I guess if we see the dude start, like, freaking out like that, we need to watch the fuck out so it doesn't blow us up. Get down here and... oh. Why can you not hit anybody with that spell? Very strange. Very strange indeed. Alright, well, whatever. I suppose. Feel free to blow the hell out of all these guys with all of your fire or all of your attacks. I guess. Just nuke them! Pretty damn effectively, just nuke these guys, basically. That'll do a bunch of healing. We will have to rest, but that's okay because it's about to not really matter. For the most part, it simply won't matter here in a minute once we,
entirely worthless.
And you can use your special ability on this guy to drop him on the ground and blow him the fuck up, and then he's dead. And we have cleared them with no difficulty, really.
Can't do that.
And that actually is gonna have to be the end of the episode. So we will clear out this other group up here next time, and probably rest, and then we'll have to go into the Burning Library itself at that point. So I will see you folks then. Take it easy, have a good day, and thank you folks for watching. Bye-bye.